This is the Glasspar Seafair, 17 foot, made in the late 50s. It's an extremely refined bottom for its day and age. It's got a V bottom, and it's got sort of an air trap on the side with some trip chines so it doesn't trip out. The guy who designed it, Bill Tritt, T-R-I-T-T, he was very innovative, and the company, Glasspar Company, under his direction, made money, which is pretty unusual in the industry. It had a cabin, and it was made for pocket cruising in the 50s, which was very, very popular. He did an incredibly good job of designing. He put a transom setback, which was somewhat unusual for that day and age. And it gives the boat a little additional length. It gives the boat a little bit more vertical stability when it's going over waves. And it works very well in this particular case. This boat was designed for a Mark 78, which was a 70 horsepower, the biggest engine at the time. The steering originally was on the other side, was on the port side. This engine that's on there now is a 1963 Merc 1000, which in its own right was a very innovative engine, kind of ended the day and age of outboards, and people bought boats with 100 horse rather than buying a Wolverine, let's say, with a Mark 58A or Johnson 35 horsepower or an Evinrude. They became just 100 horse or whatever because this engine looked so large and so unapproachable that people just put them on the boat and just said, I got 100 horse. This boat has been redone. It's had all the floors have been replaced, all the stringers underneath encapsulated, and the seats have been changed. Originally the seats swung down from the side, something that I was not aware of at the time I did this, but they did swing down from the side, which gave you even more room. This boat has a couple of features that were very innovative for the day and time. It has a sound reflector, because the engines were noisy, and it also it would keep the exhaust gases from coming in over the transom easily. He added this, and Bill Tritt also, instead of having the tops fastened to the front windshield, which most of the boats did at the time, this boat overhangs the windshield, so now the air can come in from the windshield and pressurize this space in here in the cabin and keep out, be a further deterrent to exhaust gases from coming in. This boat is set up now with a ride guide steering system, push-pull cable, single cable. Originally it had a steering wheel, as I said, on the port side, and that was a rope and pulley. This boat also has a windshield wiper and a couple of things that were standard at the time. I couldn't understand how, if you were at the mooring with you sleeping up front, how you'd keep rain out of the back. And this boat had a full canvas. It still does. It comes all the way to the back, and side curtains to keep the rain out from the back area when you're at anchor. And now we'll go forward. Had a folding top door with a latch. The top door was held by a rather innovative squeeze system. As you can see, a little knob thing up there. And when you close the door, it has two spring-loaded ball bearings which hold it closed. The lights in this are the original sockets, but they're LED now so that there's very little battery drain. The windows, when you wake up in the morning, you're looking out at the windows right here, and you can virtually see, even when you're lying down on your back, you can see all around. I will lie down in a position, and you can see out the windows, which is kind of cool. And it's got a great view. When I put this boat back together again, I epoxied the hull and the deck with fastened them again with bolts, and then I put a half inch plywood underneath all the decks to give it rigidity and strength, and then put in flotation and glued that in on in and after the plywood. The windows on this boat have been fixed with slide locks. Originally didn't have those. And you can see them right there to keep the windows from sliding back underway. And those were a recent addition. And then up forward, we have the chain locker or the anchor locker. You can see the four tabs that hold it, the cover in place, so water won't come back. And we have the hatch, which came with this. This one's had a been again reinforced, so you could walk on top of it. It works quite well. I've made screens which fasten to these little dot fasteners, and I've made screens for the two side windows that fit in place, and you slide the window all the way back, they snap into the grooves, and for the back door, one that fits in place when that's folded down. Now, you can see the forward deck has been changed somewhat too. I've put the hawse hole that came standard on these was quite a bit smaller. I made it quite a bit larger so you can feed the line back down inside of the locker. And I added some tubing, some railing, which had been on there. Had been some rails on it. They were missing when I got it, but you could see where they'd been. And I went online to see what other people had done, and I really liked this open situation of rails down both sides, and I put a lot of non-skid on the deck so I can come up here and pull the anchors and deal with the anchors and run forward from the cabin. And I reinforced the top covers. I redid the ribs up top on the underside so it was a lot stronger, and I also made the front cover so it closed very tightly.